Yo, peace one two. What's up, y'all? Yours truly, D Prime 215 here. If you're watching, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to yours truly. I'd appreciate that. Speaking of subscribing, I recently passed 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. Very, very, very grateful for that. This is a one-man show. I don't have, you know, a content team or anything like that. I'm not an influencer. It's not something I aspire to become. If it happens, it happens. I'm just someone with, you know, who's passionate about and knowledgeable about what they speak on. They happen to be pro wrestling in this particular case. So I do appreciate y'all rock with me. I do have some special 1,000 subscriber-esque videos that I'm working on, so stay tuned for that. As for this video, I'm going to talk about CM Punk, his return promo on Monday Night Raw. First time back on Raw in about a decade, give or take. So I'm going to talk about how I feel about it and what I've seen others say and how I, you know, can understand how other people may feel about it. So without any further ado, get right into it. So first things first, WWE, I do like how they went about it. If this was AEW, it would have been the very first thing and then I would have dropped off. That's just what I would have done, and I'm sure a lot of other people would have done that as well. Instead, they had to stay up all night to the very end to watch Punk come out and make his return promo. As a result, we were watching the entire show. We were more or less invested in the whole show and not just watching Punk and dropping off. So I do like that. I think that was pretty clever of WWE to keep us engaged throughout the whole show. As for the promo, it was pretty concise. It was rather short. Was it the greatest promo Punk ever did? No. To be blunt with you, I wasn't expecting it to be groundbreaking or blockbusting or any of that type of stuff. Why? Because he came back to WWE, and WWE, for all intents and purposes, is just not AEW. Punk cannot do, not so much Punk, but just in general, like the amount of things that would fly in AEW just will not fly in WWE. Just can't do that. So I wasn't expecting him to come back and do a promo like he did when he came back to AEW the first time, or when he came back, you know, and, you know, started AEW Collision. I wasn't expecting any of that. He did essentially what I thought he would do. Be a bit more, for lack of a better term here, politically correct. He was very heavy on thanking the fans. He said he changed. He said he's home and, you know, all this, that, and the third. And I'm like, okay, I see what it is. And I think it made perfect sense for him to do. I wasn't expecting him to take shots at any AEW people. I know that's what a lot of people would have liked. I would have liked that myself too, but, you know, I understand the environment. I can't expect him to do that. And at the same time, he already did that. You know what I mean? Like, if I want to see him take shots at the people he was beefing with, I can go on YouTube right now and pull up the promo and watch him talk about, you know, counterfeit butts and yada yada action figures. He already did that. Like, if he did that again, what point would it be? Like, the internet's forever. We can just go back and watch it again, right? So it would have been nice. Again, I understand that, but it's like, it's unnecessary at this point. So I do understand a number of people, they were saying they were disappointed in it. A lot of people also pointed out, like, the hypocrisy of it. And I completely understand that, you know, because I thought back to, not even so much thought back, because, you know, a lot of people were posting, you know, promos from AEW. And one particular one that stood out to me amongst many was the promo he had against MJF, where he was telling MJF, like, hey, like, don't go to the other side because the grass isn't greener. And for all intents and purposes, unless I'm told otherwise, I think we could say he was referring to WWE. So for him to get fired from AEW, then go to WWE after telling MJF to not go to WWE, and the whole buy one, get four free pay-per-view line he had, I just think that's comical. It just is. Like, it's fact or stranger than fiction. Like, none of us saw how any of this would turn out unless you have the crystal ball. And you have the whole future laid out. You don't know what's going to happen. The rest of us ain't know that. So seeing all this, it is the irony. Like, it's not lost on me. It's not lost on all of us who see that. So I completely understand that. And, you know, I know Punk is very, very polarizing. A lot of people love him. A lot of people hate him. however you feel about Punk, I personally don't care because I don't know him. He doesn't know me. Like, this is just my opinion on something that, you know, I'm obviously knowledgeable of and, you know, to an extent and passionate about. Otherwise, I wouldn't be making this video. I'm not here to, you know, talk out of my ass or anything. So, yeah, that's how I feel about the promo, man. I think he said what he needed to say. It was exactly what needed to be done. I was not expecting the AEW-esque promo. This is not AEW. A lot of stuff he did there, we all know, is not going to fly in WWE. It's just not. Like, if you look back to when he was doing the pipe bomb, like, they cut the mic. Like, he can't do that. Like, the media scrum it all out. That could happen there. And a lot of stuff he did there, that would happen there. But you can't do that in WWE. It's just a whole different situation. So, I get it, man. That's how I feel about it. He said what needed to be said. What do you guys think? Did you love it? Did you hate it? With that being said, though, you know, if you do decide to leave your opinion in the comments, I welcome it. Again, I don't really feel away how you feel about Punk. It is what it is. You're free to feel how you feel. But if you can, try to think about the big picture. Don't just think about, like, if you love Punk or hate Punk. Think about the big picture when you do decide to give your feedback. Like, how WWE is, how AEW is, what was allowed in one company, what is allowed in another company or isn't allowed in another company. And think about it from that perspective, you know, if you decide to give your feedback, not just on my video, but if you go on anyone else's. So with that being said, thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to yours truly, DPrime215. And, you know, we'll see what's next for Chicago Made, Cookie Monster, Chick Magnet. What's the other CM Punk? Whatever all the CM stand for, CM Punk, we'll see what it's hitting for, man. You know, hopefully this pans out, because I know I already said in the video, but I'll leave it with this. I think CM Punk went back to WWE because he wants to end his wrestling career on his terms. You look back to his first run with WWE, ended on terrible terms. Didn't wrestle for 7 years, so it's evident to me he doesn't need to do this. He decided to come back. He joins AEW, gets fired from AEW. Not just fired, but his run was like start and stop. He got injured. You know, it wasn't a great run. Like, even if he didn't get fired, it's just like the timing was just terrible between, you know, injuries and everything. So that was a very unceremonious exit. And I think he's like, look, if I came back to wrestling, I would end wrestling on my terms. That's how I feel looking at this from the outside looking in. So with that being said, man, I'm out for real this time. It's almost like a real life. Like, I'll tell people bye like 3 times before I actually leave. If I like you. A whole other conversation. But anyway, man, I'm out for real this time. Let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you for watching. And you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? We'll stay tuned to see what's next for Punk. All right, be good. Peace.